Hello, and welcome to another YFA Basics video. My name is Dan Landerman, and today we're going to talk about profile changes and how YFA can help you automate your profile and profile changes. So for real quick orientation, all of the reclosing devices that look like this, and the normally closed ones, all have the same profile changes enabled, and all the normally open points have the same profile changes enabled. We'll take a quick look at where you do that and set those rules up. They're within the topology editor. And if I go within the normally closed devices, we're first going to see right below there, we're going to see the profile mode rules. And there are a number of triggers in here. For all these, I've set them up to say when the feeder is in the normal topology, after it detects that, we want to switch the profile over to the normal profile, which will be number one. If YFA is going to add a zone beyond the normal feeder topology, and if YFA knows it's going to do that, before it does that, it will transition to alternate profile number 4. Alternate profile number 4 is going to show up as a 5 on the diagram. And if once the zone is actually added, and so we've added a downstream zone beyond the normal feeder topology, after it detects that, it should switch the profile over to profile number 5, alternate profile 5, which will show up as a 6 on the actual diagram. Okay, now that we know how we expect it to work, let's see that in action. In this case, let's add this zone here onto this purple feeder, and let's see if it detects it. We'd expect this device to transition to a 6, because it's going to, after it detects that it's picked up this extra load here. So I'm going to come into the simulator, I'm going to open this device, can open. I'm going to close this device, and after it detects that that's been closed in, it should switch over the profile to a 6. Now you'll also notice that this device switched its profile over to a 4. It did that because now this normally open point is fed off of feeder 4. If I go back into my topology editor and look at the normally open point profiles and the profile mode rules, we can see just for the first one that if it's fed off of source 1, it's going to be in the normal profile, which is going to show up as a 1 on a diagram. And then off of source 2, it goes to a 2. Source 3, it'll be a 3. When it goes to source 4, the diagram is going to show it as a 4. Switching back to my diagram real quick, I can now come into this system and let's do return to normal. Now, as I do a return to normal, I expect this device to switch its profile back to profile 1. However, this device, it won't be fed off of any particular source. So let's see what happens with it. It should return to normal command, close in that device, and open that one. And we'll notice that this device switched its profile back to number 1 because it's in its normal topology. But this one stayed at 4 because now it's not fed by either feeder. And so it just stayed in the profile it was. There was no new trigger to change back to any one particular profile. So we left it in profile 4 at that point. If I was to drop voltage on this feeder, and let's segment this off. So let's make sure we can't pick up here. So I'm going to set this device out of service. And now let's drop voltage here. YFA should open this device, and now we should see these upstream devices change profile before it closes in, and then we expect this one to become a 3. So I expect these to transition to a 5, we'll close that guy in, and then they'll transition to a 6, and that's what they did. And then this normally open point, because it's fed off feeder 3, now transitioned to a 3. I hope you enjoyed this YFA Basics video on using YFA to get your system to automatically change your device profiles. If you'd like more videos like this, don't be afraid to hit that like button. Thank you.